Merry Christmas, one and all! That's right, ladies and gentlemen, it's the most wonderful time of the year. And to celebrate, we here at Sunset are going to take you through the evolution of some of the greatest Christmas films of all time.
Dedicate this house to the Griswold family Christmas. Drum roll, please.
Joy to the world!
The lights must be broken.
Tonight you'll be visited by three spirits, Ebenezer Scrooge.
Bah, humbug. I don't believe in such things. Oh, spirits. Spirits, it's going to be a long night.
Santa Claus?
It's got Calvin.
You're flying away!
Oh, don't worry about it. I lived through the 60s.
Oh.
Oh, I'm a wet-handed. Oh, I'm gonna rob your house. Oh, oh.
Merry Christmas, you filthy animal.
Oh my God.
And a Happy New Year.
Ah, hey, Howard. Ah, your wife's cookies. They're out of this world.
Who told you you could eat my cookie?
Oh, there's cookies. I gotta get the recipe from Liz.
Put the cookie down now.
I'm an idiot.
You're an idiot.
All right, fine. I'm going to whisper. So that by the time my voice reverberates off the wall and gets back to me, I won't be able to hear it.
You're an idiot.
Who is it?
It's Christmas carolers.
Okay, people, 10 a.m. tomorrow morning, Santa's coming to town.
Santa? Oh my God! Ah, Santa, here! I know him, I know him!
Okay, he'll be at 10 a.m. tomorrow morning. Just keep your receipts.
10 a.m. tomorrow?
Santa's coming. It's beginning to look a lot
like Christmas. Teacher says every time a bell rings, an angel gets its wings! Who the heck are you, mister?
I'm Chris Angel, and what the heck are these?
All right, everybody, get in! Okay, everyone, 1, 2, 3, let's start the show. 1, 2, 3,
let's start the show!
Good evening and Merry Christmas, everyone! Welcome to our Sunset Christmas Extravaganza. Tonight on the show, we celebrate our last episode in the spirit of the season. Now, let's get on with the merriment with a scene from the Children's Hospital earlier this evening. 'Twas the night before Christmas, when all through the house, not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse.
Tom! Did you hear, man? They got free eggnog downstairs!
Leo, what are you doing here, man?
Oh, man, I was just like, I saw a note on your desk and it said you'd be here tonight. Yeah.
I didn't leave a note on my desk.
Alright, you got me. It's across the street at the bar and I followed you in.
Well, I'm just reading a story to the kids here.
Oh, your story? Oh, hang on. Scooch up, kids. Make way for Uncle Leo.
Oh, goodness.
Oh, see, hey, listen.
Yeah. The stockings were hung by the chimney with care, in the hopes that St. Nicholas would soon be there.
Looks like he's here already. Did he steal that hat, Tom? Because that's all, mate.
Oh, Leo, I did not steal the hat from Kris Kringle. The children were nestled, all snug in their beds, while visions of sugar plums danced through their heads.
Oh man, that'd be great with this eggnog? Some powdered sugar donuts. You got any, mate?
Leo, I don't have any powdered sugar donuts. When out on the lawn, there arose such a clatter, I sprang from my bed to see what was the matter. Away to the window, I flew like a flash, like the down of a thistle, and threw up the sash.
Uh-oh, here comes the sash near.
Oh. We are gonna get sued. When what to my wondering eyes did appear but a miniature sleigh and 8 tiny reindeer.
Well, I've got to tell you, I'm seeing like 72 miniature reindeer over here.
With a little old driver so lively and quick, in a moment I knew it must be Saint Nick. He spoke not a word, but went straight to his work and filled all the stockings, then turned with a jerk.
I'll tell you who's a jerk. That Grinch. That's not on stealing all those Christmases. It's bang on impractical. And pretty nasty too.
Yep, Yep, I hear he's a pretty downright awful guy. He sprang to his sleigh, to his team, gave a whistle. And away they flew like the down of a thistle. But I heard him exclaim as he drove out of sight, Merry Christmas to all, and to all a good night. Thank you, children. Well, it's always nice to see old friends at Christmas, I guess. But I have to remember I have a meeting with some lawyers and some angry parents later. But anyway, it's that time again to get the latest news of the world of entertainment with our wonderful correspondent, Caitlin Charles. Caitlin, can you hear me? Caitlin!
Tom, hey, oh my God, how are you?
Well, Christmas season is upon us. I'm good, how are you? You seemed a bit out of it just now.
Oh, I'm sorry. We've just been having such a good time. I guess I needed a bit of a rest.
Well, where are you at the moment? That doesn't look like Tunisia.
Oh, it totally isn't. Not even close. We won't believe where I am, Tom.
Oh, you're not going to make me guess, are you?
Okay, fine. Get this. Right now, I'm experiencing the wondrous festivities of the Venice Film Festival. Can you believe it?
Oh my goodness. Really? How? I didn't even know we got invited to go and report there. That's amazing.
Oh, it really is, Tom.
I mean, that must speak a lot about what we're doing here as a show, to get invited to such a prestigious event like that.
Well, let's not get ahead of ourselves.
Well, why not? We're only three episodes in and already making inroads in the media landscape.
Yeah. Mm.
After all the hard work, it's really paying off for us.
Tom,
it really is.
I snuck in. We weren't invited.
Oh, well, you see, viewers, we'll go to any lengths to bring you the best in entertainment news. And with an event like the Venice Film Festival, I'm sure that Caitlin has got some amazing stories for us.
Well, no, actually.
You're killing me, Caitlin. Come on, it's the season of giving, and you're surrounding by celebrities. You're surrounded by celebrities. Surely you have something.
No.
Upcoming news on movies or reviews?
No.
Stupid gossip about their first world problem?
No.
How's that possible?
Well, there were just so many waiters and waitresses with free drinks walking around. I started with one, and then it turned into five.
Five? Five? You're supposed to be working, not drinking.
I was just so nervous, and by the time I was ready to report, the booze kicked in, and the rest is just history. But I got invited to the after party, so I'll get the news for next week.
Oh, no, but this is our last show.
Well, in that case, bottoms up.
Okay. Well, that was merry, I guess. Well, let's move on to something I know will be more festive. Sonny, what do you and your sister have in the way of traffic and weather news?
Well, thanks, Tom, and happy holidays. Now onto the weather. Now, usually I'm not a big fan of anything that isn't bright and sunny, but this weather forecast shows that the weather is a bit frightful. But the fire is so delightful and, hey, what's going on in there?
Terribly sorry, folks, but this Christmas special will be ending now.
No, you gotta stop her.
No, grab her.
Wait, what? What? No, 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 no. Quick, who let you in? No!
Use the
no!
door!
Who are you?
Quick.
Hey! Hey! Hey!
All right, put Sonny back on with the weather.
All right then, now let's look back at the map. I almost forgot to mention this rough bit up the top of the map here. Well, doesn't seem like there's going to be any traffic this episode. I guess that's because everyone's on their Christmas holidays. Well then, back to you, Tom.
Oh, now that's what I'm talking about. Some real Christmas spirit. So while we all still have that warm Christmassy feeling, let's have a well-earned break and go have some milk and cookies. We'll be back after this ad break.
This is Jay. She looks very happy, doesn't she? Well, that tends to happen when you meet someone special.
Do you happen to have a USB port? Because my memory stick is full.
But when the person you love is a time-traveling robot, things can get out of hand pretty quickly.
You told me you gave that up, that you would never do it again.
I am sorry, Jane. Time-traveling is in my code.
Jack Human as the robot.
If these hard drives could cry, they would short circuit with emotion. It is my destiny to travel these avenues of time alone.
Oh, and Lucy Blast is in this too.
No, they're our avenues of time.
Hey, welcome back everyone to the Sunset Christmas Special. Now we have Kayla with some social meriadia.
Thanks for the amazing intro, as usual, Tom. Now my producers have asked me to address something straight up tonight in social media. They have told me that we'll not be reading out anything with the hashtag WhatTheDuck, because all of you are clearly very, very ill. There is no duck on the set anywhere, and there never has been. We have no idea what you're all talking about. Now onto the actual business of social media. When looking through all of the tweets, emails, and Facebook posts we've gotten over the last week here at Sunset, there has been a recurring theme of all you lovely people saying thank you and goodbye. Well, thank you to all the people who have written nice things to us. We really appreciate it. For example, at Billy Two Shoes, who says, "You guys are so funny. Hashtag sarcasm." Wow, Billy, thank you so much. I'm so glad you think our sarcasm is funny. We work really hard on keeping it subtle in the show, so it's good to see it get recognised. Anyway, moving away from that theme, now I'm going to talk about the lack of Christmas-themed messages. I'm very disappointed. Tom even told you last week that it was our Christmas special, and not one of you listened. Shame on you.
Well, hang on, Kayla. Don't get too angry. We've got a letter in the post. Just open it up for us.
Well, I guess I could. I mean, it's a social media segment, not a mail video on YouTube.
Just read the damn letter.
Fine, fine.
Hurry up. It'll be Christmas before you open it.
It is Christmas. It's our Christmas episode. Why does no one listen?
Oh, yeah, I keep forgetting.
Right. Anyway, I've got it open. Let's have a read. Merry Christmas to all the cast and crew of Sunset. You guys light up my evening. Aw. You're so funny and amazing, and that host Tom is so dreamy. Love, Mott Hulurey. Oh my God, that is just so sad. I think that just about wraps up social media for the season. See you later, everyone. Thank you for tuning into social media on Sunset.
Ah, doesn't it just warm your heart when someone in this modern day and age will put pen to paper at this time of year to share love and kind words, truly showing the real meaning of Christmas. Oh, anyway, on with the Christmas fun. Let's head over to the sports news. Have you two gotten over your little disagreement from last week?
Yes, Tom, we have. I decided to be the bigger man here and just let it all go.
Yes. Hello, hello, and Merry Christmas to all our viewers out there.
Or as they say in Uganda, Seku Kulu.
That's right, Brent. A very big hello to our loyal viewers in Uganda. Did you hear that Sunset is now the number one rated show over there?
Yes, I did, and not a big surprise, really. It was bound to happen sooner or later.
Exactly right. Anyway, on to the news. And what a week it's been. Isn't that right, Brent?
Absolutely, Jordan. In the lead up to Christmas, the annual Santa Sleigh Billy Cart Derby was held in Sydney on the weekend. It was a magical day, lots of strippers dressed as Mrs. Claus, free beer, and even Santa made an appearance for the kids. Yeah. Granted, Santa was actually just some bloke called Barry with a fake beard wearing football shorts and a singlet. Instead of a sack full of presents, he had an esky that was full of VB, but it was a nice touch.
Yeah, it was a great day for all ages to enjoy. In other news, this year's Boxing Day Test match will be like none other with some new additions to the rulebook. This year, to add a bit more excitement to the game, ICC has announced that there will be actual boxers on the field that will be roaming around the oval and starting fights with random players when the game gets a bit boring.
What a great idea, and speaking of cricket, Christmas time means the start of backyard cricket season. And our longtime supporter of our three episodes, Sam Carr, sent in this fantastic video of him and his mates playing a game of backyard cricket on the weekend. Check it out.
Can't touch.
He's hit it.
At least it wasn't his jingle balls.
Seriously, Tom, that was all you could come up with. That was awful. It's our last episode, and that's all you had. Anyway, that's all we have time for tonight. Back to you, Tom.
Jingle balls? Really?
I don't know.
Jingle balls. Wow, that was a good one. That was a good one. All right, let's keep up with this joyous atmosphere by bringing out the most enthusiastic person I know, who has a great deal for us to get all that last-minute Christmas shopping done. A very warm season's greeting to Jaikob!
Well, it's great to be back again, Tom, for our last ever advertorial segment here on Sunset.
Well, thanks for coming back, Jaikob, even after last week's disaster.
Yes, Tom, well, you win some and you lose some. And well, it turns out no one wants a desk mounted vacuum cleaner.
Yeah, well, it's quite strange, I know, but I'm like, mine, it's great!
Thanks, man, that really means a lot to me.
You're welcome, it's the season of giving after all. Anyway, Jaikob, tell us what winning product you have for us tonight.
I'm glad you asked, Tom, because I have something that's just simply amazing. Something so outstanding, you'll be blown away.
Oh, geez, you're talking this one up big time, Jaikob. What could it be?
Well, Tom, it's not another product that looks like a microwave, I can tell you that much.
Oh, stop it, Jaikob, you're killing me.
All right, Tom, we have for you the one, the only Super Liquid Mega Porter Heatermax 2000.
Wow, that's the longest name I've ever heard.
That's right, Tom. Not only does the Super Liquid Mega Porter Heatermax 2000 have the longest name ever, but it's also the greatest product we've ever sold here on the show.
Oh, but why, Jaikob? Why?
Well, this beauty is the latest in liquid warming technology. It can heat up any kind of liquid and any type of liquid, provided that it can fit in the compartment and is at least 98% water.
Tell me more!
Well, not only does it heat 98% water-based liquids, Tom, but it's also 100% portable. Yes, that's right, you can heat liquids on the car, heat them at home, heat them in the park, even heat them in the footy game.
Heat them at the footy game? Whoa! That's my favourite place to heat things up!
That's right, Tom, you can do all this heating on the go, provided you bring along a generator to plug the Super Liquid Mega Porter Heatermax 2000 into.
Wow, that's outstanding, Jaikob. What a one-of-a-kind, mind-boggling product. How can I get one?
Well, Tom, they aren't cheap, especially considering these unique products. Only two exist in the world.
Only two? What? That's crazy!
That it is, Tom. So crazy. Whoever buys these bad boys is in for a real treat forever, because they will be one of two to own the Super Liquid Mega Porter Heatermax 2000.
Oh, enough jibber-jabber. How much?
All right, Tom, all right. Your viewers can get the Super Liquid Mega Porter Heatermax 2000 for just the low, low price of either my mortgage or my car loan. It's entirely up to them.
Wow, that's an amazing deal. Sign me up right now.
Wait, really? Well, here you go, man. The other one's in my car. I'll get it for you.
Well, this is just amazing.
Merry
I can't
Christmas.
Believe it. I'm so lucky. Do you take a check?
I'll take whatever you got, man.
Well, I haven't got anything. A check, but I'm sure I can figure something out for this amazing deal. Well, that's it for tonight's advertorial, everyone. I bet you're all so jealous of me right now. I've just bought myself the greatest Christmas present in the world. Well, I'll see you guys after the break for more Sunset the Christmas Special. It's that festive time of the year, a time for friends, family, and loved ones. But sometimes just getting through that one time of year you actually ever see these people can be tough. So that's why this year, how about getting yourself a little something special to get you through the holidays? Like for instance this Christmas eggnog, to give you a little bit of that Christmas cheer. And this is perfect for when you have those relatives who just can't shut up about asking you how your life is going. So order now and bring a basket of joy to these holidays.
Welcome back, folks, and wow, those were some good deals. I've got my Christmas shopping list done and dusted, so dashing along to our next segment. Okay, well, we've had our fair share of issues with this segment, seeing as it's Christmas.
It's not actually Christmas, you realise?
Well, guys, for the purpose of this episode, it's Christmas, alright? And in keeping with the giving spirit of Christmas, I'm determined to give away this cash prize, so let's get this jingle going all the way. Now, those of you who are fans of our show, yeah, that's right, a shout out to the two of you, how you doing? But you will know that our loot line is off doing some soul searching nowadays.
Yeah, like at the bottom of a bottle.
but we can't have a money menagerie without an animal. So, ladies and gentlemen, I give you the richest reindeer.
Shouldn't the animal be like all year round, like, I don't know, the bounty bunny?
Oh, well, I thought about this, but you know, being our last episode and all, I whatever. Let's just get this money away, huh? All right, now. Now, do you guys hear that?
On the fifth day of Christmas, and something gave something fantastic.
Oh, Leo, what are you doing here, mate?
What? What's happening, man?
I'm not too much. I don't think you can sing that song in this time slot.
Well, I just thought I'd pop down just for Christmas and I'll give you a present. I'll give you a present.
Oh.
Tom?
What? You just said my name right. Did you just...
No,
you
I
just
did
said
so.
My name. And you cut me a present. Leo, I feel bad that I haven't got you anything. I tell you what I could do. No one has won our money menagerie prize yet. If you answer this question...
If you answer this question correctly, you, sir, could be going home with $49.99.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, so for the prize, the grand prize, what is my name?
Mott!
Close enough! Finally! Oh! Well, that's the end of the Money Menagerie for this season. Will you take us out, Leo? Leo, it'd be great if you could.
All right. And good night to all, and a Merry Christmas.
Oh, no, mate. I just meant if you could take us to the next segment. Anyway, we have a very special Christmas-themed guest coming up. So, everyone, are you ready for the most Christmassy interview you've ever seen? We have in the house tonight the big man, the one and only.
Is it Santa?
It is not Santa Claus. It's Sven Reins, everybody. Sit right there. Sven Reins! Wow, yes. Sven Reins, it's a pleasure to have you here.
Hello, everybody. How are you today?
Very well, Sven. Thanks for asking. You're pretty much the first guest to do so.
Yeah, that's how we do things in the North.
Well, that's terrific. Speaking of the North, tell us a bit about your job up there as a reindeer trainer.
Well, my job as a reindeer trainer is to get the reindeer ready for Christmas Eve. You know, every day is important. Every day, you know, we do leg day. Every day to get strong. You know?
So how does the average day go for you?
Well, we get up about half hour early before we go to bed, and we go lick the North Pole clean, and then we take a run over 4,000 kilometers to our neighbor.
Wow, you guys must be super fit.
Yeah, well, the routine used to be a little bit tougher, but then the reindeer started to die off, and now they're becoming extinct, so, you know, it's... I can't push them as much as I used to now.
That sounds much healthier there, Sven.
Well, no, I mean, the reindeer, they do much better when you give them like a handful of pills.
Wait, you mean like sugar pills, right? Like something cute?
No, if he gives them hard ecstasy, you know, it gets the blood pumping.
Hard ecstasy? I've heard of doping horses, but reindeer, Sven, what's happening?
Well, I mean, come on, how else does Santa get around all night, you know? It's not the magic of Christmas, it's the magic of Sven.
Well, you see, Sven, that's probably not the best thing for the reindeer. They could probably die from the drugs. Yeah, they aren't good.
Yes, many reindeer will die, but it's no problem, you know. So when the reindeer dies, their food for the rest of them, and they can still eat and get ongoing and be ripped.
Well, it's probably not too good for them either. It's a mix of cannibalism and ecstasy, then. That can't be good for anyone there, Sven.
Oh, no. They get very good at running, you know. They slay all day and all through the morning.
Well, Sven, I think we've heard quite enough about the reindeer. But before you go, can you tell us a little bit about the big man himself?
Ooh, Rudolf? Oh, yeah. Let me tell you a secret about Rudolf. His nose is red because once I gave him too much ecstasy.
Oh, I actually met Santa there, Sven.
Oh, yeah, well, Santa, he's an okay guy, you know. He sleeps a lot and you know, his elves, they do too much overtime, but he's a good man to go drinking with, yeah.
All right, well, I think that's about all we need to hear from you tonight. Sven Reins, everybody! All righty, Sven Reins. Well, as the sun sets on Sunset, we thank you again, all our lovely guests we've had this season. Robbed, Lucy Blass, and Sven Reins. But more importantly, thank you to all of our cast. Sonny, Kayla, Jaikob, Caitlan, Jordan, and Brent. And I guess Leo the Loot Lion as well. But from all of us here at Sunset, we hope you enjoyed tuning in as much as we did making the show for you all. So we will see you all next time for our next big adventure. Once again, I'm Tom LeHuray, and Merry Christmas to you all, and to all a good night.
Stacy? F-E.